Where they put to task leadership of parliament to summon the house from the break to respond to address issues of gross abuse of public funds leveled against the parliament.
Would be calling for the signing by members to have parliament recalled, because without parliament we are nowhere. But we trust that the speaker can salvage the situation. It is not too late. Of course it's bad enough, but it's not too late. We need to have the answers.
Legislators noted that the allegations of corruption which have been unearthed by the ongoing parliament exhibition have put members of parliament at risk to start fearing for their life in public.
We smuggle ourselves into parliament, we bolt out. It's not now the best time to be identified as a member of parliament. Now there is a very important issue that is happening in the country. Members of the press, as you are aware, there is the grand meeting being called in Masaka by the so-called Pirao, calling everybody to attend the rally, the political rally in Masaka.
Sechikubo also revealed that following allegations made in public that the members of the Parliamentary Commission distributed amongst themselves funds in the name of service awards, some commissioners have gone into hiding and are no longer seen at Parliament.
I know we don't look good, but shouldn't take advantage of the virtue. Where the Speaker is in this area, the Deputy Speaker is in this area, even the commissioners themselves, they're hiding. We are here. We are returning around the corridors of Parliament. You can't see anybody. So these are very disturbing issues.
These MPs demand for a forensic audit into all the allegations that have been unearthed through social media and have it undertaken by the Auditor General and have the report findings to be scrutinized by the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises.
And then we have our specialized committees. We demand for a forensic audit by the Auditor General into all those allegations. A forensic audit. We can now mandate our committees, there is the Committee of COSASI, to look into these allegations. Let us as well, whereas we cannot stop the IGG, but as Parliament we can't sit idle, we can't fold our arms when such grave allegations are made against the institution of Parliament. Let our committee take up the mantle.
Sechikubo also revealed that members of parliament received a notice from Clerk to Parliament Adolf Mwesije informing MPs of a plenary sitting. However, the meeting was unceremoniously called off through a request from Prime Minister on grounds that ministers are absent. Sechikubo explained that stopping the plenary sitting is a strange decision.
If parliament has been called, it is an arm of government. If you choose that your ministers are not going to attend, let it be on record and explain where they are. But to receive one communication from the clerk who actually wrote on behalf of the speaker, then again you receive another letter stopping the resumption of parliament.
And we are calling on the speaker, we are calling on the deputy speaker, the clerk, to live up to their calling, to seize the mandate of parliament as given by this constitution, to restore parliament. Parliament is being run down.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.